好了。What's up, Holla Maniacs? Welcome to another episode of Holla at Your Brief Boy YouTube video. Today is a very exciting day. You know why? I'm gonna show you how I feed my reef in a box. But as you can see, there's also an acclimation box back there that shows a purple tang, a blue tang, a scopus tang, and a pair of Yasha Gobi. Now I'm introducing these guys into the tank so they can get acclimated to their new tank mates. These guys have been in quarantine for the past 35 days. So these guys are ready to be introduced into this Peninsula 650. So I can't wait for that. But you will see them up close and personal just a little bit. But today's topic is to go over what I feed my corals and my fish. You know, just like us humans, we like to try different variety of food. Why? Because number one, taste, obviously. But number two, it helps us grow and build our immune system. Because, you know, if you think about fish and corals, they are pretty much like us. If we can feed them different variety of food, it will build up their immune system to fight against parasites, diseases, and also to help them grow and flourish. So I'm gonna introduce you guys into some of the food products and things that I use personally. Now there's a lot of great products out there, but these are the products that I use personally and I have seen great results. And I will show you guys some pictures that I snap from past photos to current photos, just to show you guys the growth difference between them. All right, so are you guys ready to see what I feed my corals and fish? Woo! Yeah.
Woo, yeah.
All right, so the first product I wanna go over what I feed my corals is designed by a company called Polyp Lab. And I use two products from them that really produce great results. The first one is called Polyp Booster. And what this does, it pretty much activates the feeding tentacles from the corals. It's kind of cool is once you squirt this into your tank, you will start seeing your acans and your candy canes and start opening up their feeding tentacles. It's kind of cool. If you just wait like 10 to 15 minutes, you start seeing that. So what I recommend is before you use this product, turn off your return pump and just leave your wave maker pump on. And what you want to do is squirt, depending on your volume of water, squirt a few drops in there and let the wave maker spread it around. And about 10 to 15 minutes later, you will start seeing these feeding tentacles start extending. This is a cool thing. So you definitely want to leave your return pump on because you don't want this stuff to get wasted into the filter socks or whatever your media that you use to remove it. So you definitely want to keep this inside your display tank. Now, the second thing I do is after 10 to 15 minutes, when you notice that your feeding tentacles are extended, I take the reef roids and I get a scoop of water from the tank and I mix about a half a teaspoon or a teaspoon into the cup and I just mix it up and blend it together. And you get this kind of a thick orange color. And what I do is get a pipette or a feeder and I spot feed certain corals like a candy cane, any corals that you see noticeably with the feeding tentacles extended. And I spot feed that and the remaining liquid in the cup, I broadcast feed that. And again, I leave the wave maker pump on so that it can just circulate and spread throughout the whole tank. Now, as far as how long I leave the return pump off, I leave it off for about 30 minutes because remember, your wave maker pump is producing oxygen. So no worries about no oxygen in the tank because that's where the wave maker comes in. So I leave the tank return pump off for about a good 30 minutes to let the Reef Roys and the Polyp Booster take its course. Again, great products by Polyp Lab. I highly recommend this. The next thing I use also is a product called Benefits. This is also another great coral feeder. Cool thing about this one. This one's actually brand new. I'm trying it out now as we speak, but I heard good things about them. I will see how it goes and I'll keep you guys updated on how this product goes. But so far the tank loves it. I've only been using this product twice now in my tank. So really, again, it goes back to giving your corals and fish a variety of different food to help them grow and build their immune system. So there you go. All right, guys, now we're gonna go over what I feed my fish. Now, I feed my fish daily, like every single day. And I recommend that every reefer should have an automatic feeder. Why? Because our work schedule, our school schedule, or whatever it is that's keeping us busy in life, sometimes we forget to feed our tank. And that's why it's handy to have an automatic feeder so that your fish can at least get the minimum regimen that they need. Because your life is so busy that you can't feed them, at least they got something that will take care of them. And what I usually put in the automatic feeder is made by New Life Spectrum. Now the fish love this stuff. I mean, even the finicky eaters, the picky eaters, they love this stuff. They eat it with no problem at all. And like I said, in the morning, I usually manually feed them with this. And then my automatic feeder is on a schedule where it feed them twice a day with this stuff. The other thing that I feed my fish is for the tangs. I use Ross Food, Veggie Clip, Nori, they love this stuff, seaweed, good stuff. So what I do is take a sheet of this every single day, I put it on a veggie clip and I put it in the tank, and voila, probably like 30 minutes or so, the whole Nori is gone because the tangs love this stuff. The other thing I do is 4 to 5 times a week, I feed mysis shrimp and this called Mega Marine Algae. This is a mixture of mysis shrimp and algae that for the tangs to eat. That along with Selcon, I usually put in a couple of drops as the frozen food is thawing out in the salt water, and I just let it mix in there for about 5 to 10 minutes. And then after that, I just dump it in the tank and the fish just go at it. So these are the kind of things that I usually feed my fish on a daily regimen. Get them fat and get their immune system all strong so that they can go against any kind of disease and parasite. So I highly recommend these kind of food. But like I said, there's plenty of frozen food out there that you can try, like Reef Frenzy. I actually have that. I usually feed them that once or twice a week as well. It's just in the freezer, I didn't pull it out. But there's tons of other frozen food that other companies make that you can use. As long as you mix up the food, as long as you give them different varieties, it helps them. So nothing's wrong with feeding them different variety of food, because it's actually great for their immune system. So there you have it. All right, so check out the short clip on how I feed my reef in terms of how I use the Polyp Booster and the Reef Roys to feed the corals, and how I spot feed them and broadcast feed them. So check it out and enjoy. All right, so this first product I want to go over is by Polyp Lab. And the first thing you want to do is remember to turn off your return pump and just leave your wave maker on. And as you can see, I'm squirting some drops along the tank. And depending on your water volume, you just want to kind of go along the tank and just squirt some drops. Next thing you want to do is wait about 10 to 15 minutes. As you can see, the polyp is already beginning to extend. And this is during the daytime, where normally the feeding tentacles are not extended, as you can see here. But check out the feeding tentacles of these candy cane and the orange fungia plate. Next thing you want to do is take the reef roys and take about half a teaspoon or a teaspoon of reef roys and put it in a cup and just start mixing it until you see it becomes perfectly blend, like a deep orange color. And then take a pipette and squirt it along the feeding tentacles of your corals. In this case, I'm squirting the acans that have opened up nicely, and as you can see, they are reacting to the reef roys very well. So in the morning, I turn the lights, for example here, but the feeding tentacles of the corals are already fully extended. And what I do is I use Phytofeast and Oyster Feast by Reef Nutrition, and I feed this about 2 to 3 times a week. And I shake it up before I use it, both bottles, and I usually take a bottle each and I just squirt in the tank. For this volume of water, I just give it a good 3 squirt each. And with the wave makers on, it kind of circulates throughout the tank and the tank feeds well. And again, I do turn off the return pump while I'm doing this, because the idea is you want all this good stuff to stay in the main tank and not go into the sump. Another thing I do each morning is I feed Ross Food. I usually give the tang some good old seaweed, and I squirt some Selcon on it and attach it to Little Fishy's veggie clip and just feed my tangs. Each day coming home from work, I take out Mega Marine Algae with Mysis Shrimp and the LRS Reef Frenzy, and I take a Selcon and I drip it into the frozen food. Next thing I do is take Benepits, and I take about a teaspoon worth of Benepits, and I just kind of dazzle it over the frozen food, kind of like mixing and marinating the food. And then I take a cup of water and I begin to mix it all together and let that sit for about 10 to 15 minutes to thaw out. Next, what I do is I take the cup and I just kind of broadcast feed the whole tank. And again, remember to leave your return pump off. You want to keep all this good stuff in there. Here is the Eheim automatic feeder that I have programmed on a schedule to feed the tank twice a day. And I filled this automatic feeder with New Life Spectrum pellets, and the fish loves it. Reefers, I want to say one more thing. I want to say thank you to Flipper Cleaner for having a great contest using their deep sea viewers, something like this, as a contest to submit videos or photos of how one would use this product. Now, this is a great product because you can see your corals, your livestock, anything up close and personal when you press it against the glass. It's a great magnifier to see all your livestock in action. Now, what I did was I was feeding this a tube anemone here and using this product here, and also my yellow tang decided to do the moonwalk. Yes, I said it, the moonwalk. So check it out in this clip and hopefully you enjoy, because what it did was it won me first place and got me $200. What? Holla! Yeah. All right, so today we talked about how to feed our corals and our fish, and how it's important it is to feed a different variety of food because it helps the fish grow, build their immune system, and help them fight against parasites and diseases. As well as the corals, how it to enhance their colors, to help them grow, and all that good stuff. So today I want to bless you guys with the word of the Lord, where it will help us grow spiritually, because we need spiritual food as well. And so two verses that will bless us today comes out of 1 Peter chapter 2 verse 2, and it reads this: like newborn babies, you must crave pure spiritual milk so that you will grow into a full experience of salvation. And the second verse come out of 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 6, and it reads this: being nourished with the words of the faith. So I want to ask you guys this question. Have you ever heard that the Bible was meant to be food for us? Spiritual food, that is. Yet many of us sometimes still feel spiritually dry, thirsty, hungry, and really sometimes even empty inside. You know, we can even experience this feeling after reading the word. And why is that? Why do you think that? Have you ever experienced where when you read the word, you learn something new, you pick up something good in terms of advice, or receive some kind of inspiration, but it still doesn't satisfy us sometimes, right? Despite our studying, we still feel hungry and we continue to feel weak in our Christian walk. You know, when it's coming to books, the purpose of books is they are meant to be read, right? Now, if the book is a textbook for a class, what do? We read it, we study it, and sometimes we memorize stuff from the book. Sometimes we read a biography of a renowned person just for inspiration and encouragement, right? But what about the Bible? Is it a book we read simply for inspiration, or a textbook to memorize, to learn about God and the Christian faith? Is it a book that just instructs us how to be a good person or how to have a happy and blessed life? You know, as Christian, we certainly should read God's word regularly and even study it. But the Bible is not simply a work of literature, right? It's not just a textbook or a self-help book, right? You know, when God gave us His Word, it wasn't for us to learn about doctrines or ethics or even how-tos. It was meant for us to really to be spiritually fed. And what does spiritually fed mean? You see, our lives consist of many matters. You know, for physical survival, we have to eat food, right? When we haven't eaten in a while, it becomes very obvious that something is wrong. And a lot of things else around us become secondary, because only eating food will satisfy our hunger and nourishes us. Now, without eating, we simply just can't live. Now, in the same way, as believers, for us to have a healthy and divine life, we need to eat spiritual food. But what is the food for our spiritual life? What is this food? His Word. You see, God gave us His Word to be our spiritual food. So even more than just studying it, reading it, but we actually need to eat it, apply it. See, nothing is more important to this Christian life than being nourished with the Word of God. You see, I'm a father of two boys, and it's important to me that they grow up to be good people. It's important that they grow up and have a good education and treat everybody with respect. However, the most important matter to me at every day and every moment is to make sure they get fed. Because feeding them and making sure that their physical body get nourished and that they are healthy is important. You see, all the other things can be taken care of once they are nourished. So how do you know that the Word of God can be our source of food? In Matthew chapter 4, verse 4, Jesus said to the devil as he was tempting him that men shall not live by bread alone, but on every word that proceeds out of the mouth of God. So basically, Jesus was just telling us that we should not just live on physical bread, but we ought to live on God's Word, our spiritual bread. So in closing, my friends, God gave us His Word, the Bible, not to be our textbook, but to be our spiritual food. So make sure when you read the Word of God, apply it and pray and ask God to give you revelations on what God wants you to get from His Word. So I hope that blessed you today, my friends, as you read and grow in the Word of the Lord. Amen. All right, reefers, it's that time again. It's time for Holla at Your Reefer, Reefer Hall of Fame. What, what? Yeah. In the Hall of Fame, yeah. And the world's gonna know your name. All right, you guys ready? Excited to see who goes to the Sticker Wall of Fame today? It goes to Mr. Farm Boy Reef himself, Mr. Ryan Nash. Now, if you check out his YouTube channel and his Instagram account, you'll see how passionate he is about the reefing hobby. Now, I remember in the past, I used to look up how to do water testing or product reviews, and his channel was one of the first few channels that appeared in the search option. And I'm so glad that I came across the channel because it's so entertaining and it's great content, and I was a subscriber right away. And if you check out his channel, you'll see what I'm talking about. So today goes to Mr. Farm Boy Reef himself. Here we go. All right, you guys ready for the next Reefer Hall of Fame? It goes to Mr. Reefer Gill. Yep, yep. Man, Mr. Gill. Ooh, I love his channel. If you guys come across his Instagram and his YouTube channel specifically, you'll see what I'm talking about. I really love his channel in terms of how he does DIY, how he explains things, how he takes you on his journey of reefing. Now, he has his ups and downs, but you know what? He doesn't hide the downs. He shows it. And really, that's how I learned how to do reefing better, because watching channels like his helped me understand the mistakes better. It helped me understand not the things not to do in this hobby, as well as DIY stuff. Man, if you saw how he did his Apex cabinet, it's a beautiful piece of work. And it wasn't expensive at all. It's all DIY stuff. So go check it out, Mr. Reefer Gill. I'm really glad that he came back into uploading some videos because I really enjoy his videos and his content. So please follow him and subscribe to his channel, Mr. Reefer Gill, the next Reefer Hall of Fame. Boom. All right, so the last sticker that will go into this wall today goes to a very special company that I want to say thank you to, because their product really helped my corals grow, as well as seeing their corals in a different light. That goes to none other than the company Polyp Lab. There you go, Polyp Lab company. So I really want to give a special shout out to this company because I use their Coral View lens. You guys saw a YouTube video review that I did of that. It really helped do video and taking picture, capture the essence of the beauty of the coral for what they really are. And number two, as you guys can see, the Polyp Lab booster and the Reef Roys does wonders to the corals. I mean, it's talking about the corals actually show that they love it by their feeding tentacles coming out. And usually feeding tentacles don't come out until nighttime, but you can actually make them come and appear by using the booster during the daytime. So that's how good and how productive that product is. So I want to give a special shout out to Polyp Lab. Thank you so much. You guys rock. Here we go. Yeah. All right, guys, so that's it. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed yet, please subscribe. I really appreciate it. And until next time, I'll bless you guys. I hope you have a happy life, a happy reefing, and God bless you, my friends. Holla!